Good morning, I'm Anjali Istwal. Welcome to NDTV. This is FII, the show where we discuss issues that matter to you. Now, the festival season in India is a huge driver of consumption. And consumption makes up nearly 60% of our GDP. This is the reason why industries and even unorganized sector that produces products for consumption are a bit worried this year. Will the Indian consumers spend as they do every year this year? After all, there has been less cash flowing into their wallets this year due to salary cuts and even suspension of economic activity. So this is the question that we are asking our viewers. How exactly is COVID going to impact the Indian economy, especially during the festive season? Will the consumers come out and buy goods? Will they be spending the same way they spend every time? And joining us right now for this conversation are Mr. Arvind Mehendiratta. He's the chairperson of Fiki Retail and he's also the MD and CEO of Metro Cash and Carry. Joining us also is Sanchita Mukherjee. She's a business consultant. She's joining us from Delhi. Thank you very much for joining in. Mr. Mehendiratta, I'm going to begin with you. This is the time when industries see a massive boost of consumption and, of course, they increase their production also, keeping in mind that expected boost. This year, what has happened?
Good morning, everyone. I will say that this year is a bit different because of the pandemic and the devastation caused by the lockdown. So overall, customer sentiment is a bit weak compared to regular Diwali period or compared to regular festive period. People have smaller budgets to play around with. And we are seeing this both at the individual level as well as, you know, at the corporate level, because a lot of companies give gifts to their employees and business partners. So this time the budgets that they have are lower than what they had historically. We're also finding that because of the pandemic is still very much around us, even the Prime Minister urged the people to be more careful. So we will see smaller, more restrained celebrations versus a big, loud, large Diwali parties and gatherings that one used to see in the past. So this will also impact certain product categories. We're also finding that people are more inclined to celebrate at home with their family and near and dear ones versus going out. And there's also, interestingly, a bigger focus on gifting themselves versus giving big, lavish gifts to their business partners or friends and family. And at the end of it all, people are also looking for a safe shopping environment. So okay. These are the five or six big themes that we have seen emerge in the last, you know, 3 or 4 weeks.
Right. Sanchita, do you think that the Indian consumer is reluctant in spending this year?
So let's understand this economically. If you were to look at the retail offtake and the data month on month in the months of April, May and June, it has been absolutely dismal, right? We are in the middle of a global pandemic, and I agree with all the points Mr. Mehendiratta raised. Having said that, in the month of July, August, and September, you will see a month-on-month improvement on economic data, right? There have been green shoots which have been witnessed. So let's understand, it's not that consumption has come to a complete standstill. However, we are in a very, very unusual year. So we need to address it like that. There are consumers who are consuming. There's rural consumption happening. The offtake in cycles, two-wheelers have been there. So let's understand which are the sectors which are performing, which are not. Companies, what they need to do is use this as an opportunity. This is the time they should be looking at creating brand ambassadors within their businesses, creating influencers, understanding the fact that there is pent-up demand. And once the economy opens up, and God forbid we do not have a second wave, as is being witnessed in Europe, and things don't turn suddenly dreadful, there will be a lot of pent-up demand which will come back with a bang.
Right.
And companies need to capacitize themselves for that. They need to identify who are these consumers who are consuming.
You know, Sanchita, what you're referring to as that pent-up demand that will come back as a bang, there is another word that people say called revenge shopping. You know, China saw that after the lockdown.
Absolutely.
People just came out and they were shopping and even luxury items. Mr. Mehendiratta, do you think companies can utilize this moment to bring in that customer, and maybe the customer can also utilize this moment to get better deals?
Yes, so I will say that there is a shift in the demand. You know, it is not business as usual. And if you are a smart marketer, a smart business person, you can very well capitalize on that demand. So let me highlight a few things that we are doing differently versus what we have done in the past, and also versus some of the other people in the industry. So first of all, gifting is still going to be there. People have smaller budgets. So what we have done is we have shifted our focus towards gift articles which have a value of less than 500 rupees. So we have thousands of articles which are priced below 500. We even have hundreds of articles for gifting which are priced below 100 rupees. So it's very affordable. And we are seeing a big jump in sales for these kind of products. The second thing is, which are the categories where people are spending a lot of money? So within food, we are seeing a big bump in sale of frozen products. Frozen desserts, frozen snacking, frozen ready-to-eat products. We are seeing, you know, when the lockdown was first imposed, we saw a lot of people doing baking at home. Now the shift is towards making Indian desserts at home. So there's a big demand for basics like besan, oil, ghee, sugar, dry fruits and nuts, because people are trying to make these Indian sweets at home.
Right.
People are also preferring to buy trusted brands because they also don't want to buy something which is unknown and, you know, unwittingly catch the virus. So there's a big shift towards brands which are trusted and loyal. So within food, we are seeing a big demand for well-known products, so brands like Amul, Haldiram, etc.
Right.
The other thing that we are seeing is the shift is towards healthier snacking. So people are going snacking on products like dry fruits and nuts, and there's a big jump in demand for these kind of product categories.
Right. So, Mr. Mendiratna, maybe we should just wait for the Navratras to get over and then we'll probably see a big jump in the food sector. But joining us now is Mani Rangarajan. He's a Group Chief Operating Officer of Housing.com, PropTiger.com and Makan.com. Thank you very much, Mr. Mani, for joining in. You know, Navratras, I used to do a property show and Navratras used to be that permanent story for us year on year that, okay, real estate sector is giving all these deals. What is happening this year? Are these deals coming in? Are buyers showing any interest in real estate this year?
I mean, I think over the last 2 months, there's been a tremendous interest in buying real estate. And that's happening for a couple of reasons. So the first is that, you know, with the ongoing pandemic, people do realize that the place that they are secure the most is within the confines of their own home. So that's one. Second is that people are looking to upgrade their homes because now working from home is looking like it's going to be a trend going forward, even in the future, even after the pandemic is over. So considering that, people are looking for larger size homes. And with working from home being encouraged by a lot of corporates, a lot of people are willing to move to the peripheral areas of the city. And we are seeing a lot of demand in Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities as well. This along with the fact that, you know, the other forms of investment such as gold, the stocks, the mutual funds are all very volatile, has placed real estate as the most secure asset that people could potentially invest in. And let's also not forget that interest rates are at a 15-year low. Developers have also been very, very good to seize the occasion. And a lot of developers have come out with discounts, flexible payment plans, price protection plans, and everything possible under the sun to entice buyers to come and purchase real estate. So, in fact, on Housing and Makan, we have seen that the demand for real estate for new homes as well as resale homes has grown to more than 60% above pre-COVID levels.
Okay.
And we are seeing, like, transactions grow at a very, very healthy clip in PropTiger. In fact, last month in PropTiger, we recorded a 40% year-over-year growth. And last year was pretty good. So you can see that the demand for real estate is really picking up.
Okay. So that seems to be some good news coming in from the real estate sector. But Sanchita, do you think the COVID is going to change the consumer behavior forever? Or is it just a bump in the, you know, journey that we are seeing? That it'll just happen, they'll adapt to it for a while and then later on get back to the normal habits of spending lavishly during the festive season and going out and shopping.
I think we'll be back to a new norm once this COVID situation abates. We are actually witnessing that across sectors in terms of consumer behavior. Yes, there have been shifts, which you're talking about, and I agree there are visible shifts, but whether that's sustainable or not, we do not know. But having said that, there is pent-up demand, which is there for services, what companies need to do is to look at targeted advertising. Targeted advertising would work, because what Mr. Mendiratta was saying, I agree with that. There is a lot of interest in different things. For example, right now during the festive season, people are actually researching on handloom weavers, where they can buy, you know, handloom made saris, things like that, you know, which is a little usually not done. It's not a very often thing. People usually go to very large store formats to shop. But nowadays there's a lot of interest in patronizing your local arts, local produce. So companies could look at branding and advertising within that. It can be a very next big thing. After having said that, I think this entire discussion could also focus on the consumers themselves. If you're looking at just businesses and how they should be wooing the consumer, I would also like to look at it a little differently. Consumers in today's date, for example, may not be feeling very festive. It is not a usual time, right? We are in the middle of a pandemic. So a lot of people are actually taking their domestic helps, the drivers, the courier boys, the runners, they're opening bank accounts for them. They're opening their health insurances for them. You know, more financialization of savings. They're helping them to avail of life insurance schemes, which the government has come up with. People are not aware of that. A lot of them do not have access to laptops. You know, SBI has come up with interest rate reduction on home loans. So many of the private banks, NBFCs, are having festive offers. So what I'm witnessing is a lot of consumers actually helping a lot of people in the unorganized sector come on board and avail of these services. This should be a very sustainable trend, and it can be encouraged by businesses.
Right, absolutely. Mr. Mendiratta, you know, all these things that Sanchita is saying, apart from that, the fact that a lot of business might shift to the e-retail giants. Do you think that what physically might not be happening, the shopping, the spending, might happen online?
So we are seeing two big trends across the retail industry. One is, of course, customers are shopping online. It's true for both B2C and B2B shoppers. So there is a big shift towards online. But I must also tell you, this was probably very prevalent during the early phase of the lockdown. In September and even in October now, the shift towards physical visits to the stores has gone up significantly. We saw footfalls in September increase versus last year. October numbers are even much higher than September numbers. So we are seeing a lot of footfalls in our stores. We also realize that there's a shift towards online. So we started our online platform for Kirana customers because we are a B2B company. Now, between August and April, there was a 3x jump in business traffic and also in terms of sales that we were getting on that platform. Now, between August and October, as we speak, there's again a 3x growth in sales. So this is telling you that people are shifting towards online, and it's not just the more tech savvy, the consuming class, but also small shopkeepers are going online, because a lot of these people who are buying from us are these Kirana shop owners. The second shift that we are seeing is demand for credit. There's a big demand for credit and financing. A lot of the e-commerce companies have offered very attractive consumer finance schemes. We are seeing that even small business people are asking for credit. And we have tied with a lot of partners in the financial services space to offer credit to these customers, even loans for them to expand their business and also to stock up for Diwali. So we believe that looking at what is happening, there's a need for what we call fizzy digital. So there's a need for being an omni-channel player. Okay. People still during these times want to get out of their homes, go to a mall, go to a big store, shop, try out different products. At the same time, they also like the convenience and safety of home shopping through online. So we are seeing that people who are in the omni-channel place will ultimately be the winners in this space. I also want to highlight that there is certainly a big, while, you know, it may sound paradoxical, while people are looking for value, they're also looking for quality. So it's not that they're looking at the lowest quality products because the price points are the lowest. So we are seeing a big resurgence in demands. It's across both food as well as non-food. Right. And basis this, you know, we came out with a new campaign, which is about spreading happiness. And our focus is about 5-star quality at wholesale prices. So that in essence sums up what people are looking for. They're looking for great deals, great value, brands, but they also want to make sure they are getting the best deals.
Absolutely.
That's what exactly is going on.
Absolutely. The consumer might want a deal now, a discount now, but they're not ready to compromise on quality. That's for sure. But going back to you, Mani, why would you say, if you have to tell the consumer, this is a better time to buy, if it is? Because would I, as a consumer, if I choose to spend my money right now, would I be able to broker a better deal?
Well, there are a couple of reasons why it's a good time to buy, right? So one is when you look at real estate prices over the last few years, right, prices have really not crashed. So, you know, after demonetization, there were a lot of pundits who said that prices are going to crash. But we have seen that prices have held down. And even during the period of lockdown, you know, there have been selective deals and bargains which have been available, but developers have not slashed prices across the board by about 20 to 25%, right? The second is, you know, since the prices have not really appreciated, right? And the appreciation has in fact been lower than the consumer price index. It basically means that, you know, properties are pretty cheap, right? And given the growth that India promises to have from FY22-23 onwards, right, we're likely to see prices appreciate. So it's a good time to invest in because you're kind of going to get good capital appreciation in some cities and in some localities. So that's one. The second is that, you know, if you're looking for a home to rent in the central business district, you can find an affordable home right towards the peripheral areas of the city. And if you don't have to go to work every day and if you're allowed to, you know, work remotely, then you have the flexibility of living in a larger home and also living in a home which ultimately belongs to you. So that's another reason.
Right.
The third reason I would also say is the lower interest rates, right? The interest rates are almost like at a 15-year low.
Right,
And, you know, we're seeing home loan interest rates start, you know, slightly below 7% and goes upwards of 7%. So considering all this, you know, I think it's a great time for people to buy a new home.
Absolutely. I just have a minute left, Sanchita, but, you know, you are the best to advise the consumer right now. So what would you tell the consumer? It's time to lighten those wallets or just right now stay, be patient and keep that money and put it in a saving?
Actually, it all depends on where you are at your life cycle in terms of what is the surety of your job. You know, it's very individual specific. Absolutely. Because there are a lot of individuals, you know, who do not have a job in today's state. So, yes, stay responsible, stay safe. Spend as much as you can, but I think the focus, because it's an unusual year, should also be on the less privileged, you know, people who work for us, ensure that they get their salaries and that a little bit of financialization for them would actually help the economy in a major way. What we witnessed actually in the month of April, May, June was mass migrant people traveling towards these kind of people in the unorganized sector are not mapped. So it's very important for each consumer in today's date who has a salary, who has a COVID savings of their own, to ensure that the bank account for the domestic help, for the driver, for right. the construction worker does get opened. That's very important.
Absolutely. And if we give them that money, they will be able to spend during the festive season, have
Absolutely.
A better Diwali,
yes.
and it will benefit the country on the whole. So we have to remember that small small action of ours, paying those salaries, helping our domestic help can actually benefit the country. Thank you very much, all of you, for joining in this conversation. So we're going to take a very quick break right now. When we come back, we show you how the sweets that are the most important part of the festival season, how that is taking a hit in this COVID time. Welcome back. Markets which should be picking up business during the festive season wear a forlorn look. Sweet shops say businesses are down by around 50 to 30%. People are scared to eat out and even buy food from outside. Halwai say they've also scaled down their production as demand has gone down massively.
Hari Mishthan Bhandar, a sweet shop near Jaipur's iconic Hawa Mahal. In the festive season, it would be bustling with business. But in the backdrop of the pandemic, it wears a forlorn look. Its owner, third-generation Pradeep Jhotwani, who inherited the 80-year-old business from his grandfather, says he has scaled down production of mithais by nearly 30%.
The 1st June, ko shop opening ki thi. Uske baad se to market bilkul down. Tourist hai nahi. Log bahar nikalne nahi kyunki logon mein abhi dehshat hai. Jab tak iski vaccine nahi aayegi, tab tak koi iska ilaaj hi nahi hai. Abhi to sirf jo humne ye face pe laga rakha mask, yahi ek tarah se dawai hai, yahi vaccine hai.
So,
टोटल आपका जो प्रोडक्शन है उसमें आपने कितना कम किया है?
बहुत कम किया, मतलब 30% किया, बिल्कुल कम किया.
What is unique about these sweet shops is that their produce is still handmade. But with dropping demand, fewer hands are required. And a number of sweet shop owners have also cut back on staff or have asked them to come in only on alternate days. The drop in demand is because people are still scared to venture out and eat out.
Sale to kam hai hi, bahut kam hai. Kam nahi, bahut kam hai sale to. To abhi mandir wagaira kuch nahi khule to navratron mein prasad nahi badhta. और बाकी लेबर नहीं है लोगों के पास, लेबर गांव गई हुई है, तो कोई भी दिवाली पे मिठाई बांटने की कोई उम्मीद लग नहीं रही, तो इस वजह से अभी सेल कम ही है. लास्ट ईयर से तो बहुत कम है मैम, लास्ट
ईयर 50%.
कोरोना का डर है लोगों में कि कहीं से बाहर से कोई भी चीज़ें नहीं ली जाए. कोरोना की वजह से काफ़ी लोग हैं जो परचेज नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, घर का ही खा रहे हैं.
जितना पॉसिबल हो कि घर पर ही बनाए, घर पर ही खाएं.
कोरोना की वजह से लोग बाहर नहीं खा रहे.
जी जी.
Empty shelves and sweets not piled as high as earlier. The economic slump after the pandemic has certainly taken the flavor out of the festive season. In Jaipur, Harsha Kumari Singh, NDTV.
Well, that's all we have for you in this show in FII. We'll see you tomorrow, but news updates follow on the other side of the break.